What's up YouTube and welcome to a new video. Now in the last 3 months I made several videos in which I showed you how much the prices for some popular sports and supercars moved during the last 1 to 2 years. We will get into the details soon, but in short, most cars dipped slightly or even went up in price. And this is quite remarkable and also raises the question, did prices increase so much that we are in a bubble now? To find the answer to that question, we will first discuss what usually happens with car prices during an economic contraction. After that, I will show you how the prices develop for the cars which are analyzed on this channel and how that fits in the context of the current economic situation. At the end of the video, I will share with you my thoughts on what that might mean for future prices. Now, I don't need to tell you that the pandemic had a disruptive effect on the US economy. Last year it contracted by 3.5%, which is the largest decrease since 1946. And especially on a quarterly level this looks nasty. Now one way to find out what this should have meant for car prices is to investigate the historic relationship between the economy and the car prices. And as you might know, this might be a bit sketchy, as these type of correlations don't fare well over time. Moreover, it is very difficult to find good, freely available data on used car prices, and the data which exists out there often covers the classic car market and then especially the top end of it. For these type of collectibles and classic cars, you can find indexes like the Hagerty Market Index, the Hagi Index, and the Dox Index. So what do these type of indexes have to say about car prices? That is what we will find out now. A study published in the Journal of International Financial Markets shows that on a high level, you can see that classic and collectible cars outperform the stock market. And this, by the way, also goes for the risk-adjusted return. Depending on the time horizon you're looking at, they even outperform gold. But it's not only sunshine for collectible cars. They also sometimes go down in value. Let's have a look now at some of those periods. The first one was in the late 80s and the beginning of the 90s. Back then, there was a feeding frenzy going on, partially fueled by the strong Japanese yen. Cars were then also mainly bought for investment purposes. On top of that came then an economic recession and a spike in oil prices. Yet, after the period of decline, you can see that prices steadily increased till the 2018 financial crisis. During that period, you can see a slight dip in values, after which values started to go up again. And according to Hagerty, a company which specializes in insurances for collectible vehicles, this increase is due to a disappointing stock market performance and declining interest rates. Hence, in this particular case, a decrease in the stock market didn't result in a decrease for collectibles. Yet, from 2015 onwards, you can see that this surge came to an end and that, according to Hagerty, bloated prices are settling back to what is a sensible value. It simply shook out many people who were only in the market for investment purposes. Now we can see this boom and bust in this graph, but it is not so evident due to the scaling. It is much easier to spot from their own price index. Here you can see that after the financial crisis, values increased a lot, and you can also see a clear decrease from 2015 onwards. Now what is interesting here is that prices didn't decrease equally for all markets. From this graph you can see that the more expensive the car, the larger the price drop. Cars under $100,000 didn't really decrease. Now according to Hagerty, this is because these cars are first and foremost bought as fun objects rather than investments. Moreover, high-end sport cars from the 80s and 90s actually started to gain traction in 2017. And these cars are of course the poster cars for the millennials, which by then started to build some wealth. It is even so that when we look at the Hagerty price index for cars under $30,000, we can see an almost exponential increase in values. And this contrasts to all of their other indexes, like the one for British cars, Porsches and Ferraris. They all show a flat development. So we established that collectible values usually trend up, but that in some periods of economic contraction, they also go down. Also, this is not just based on the anecdotal evidence which I just presented to you. If you look up some research papers, you will find that the correlation between collectible values and the stock market is actually quite low, just as it is for other alternative investment categories. But in any case, we know now in which context we need to see the prices at the starting point of the pandemic. They are cooled down after a big boom. So let's have a look now as to how the used car price has developed over the last 1.5 to 2 years. The graph over here has the date on the horizontal axis and the price on the vertical axis. And you can consider this graph as an aggregation of the videos which I showed you over the last few months. There is a large variation of cars included. We have the Audi R8 market, the 720S market, a few Corvettes, the F-Type, the 991 market, the Cayman 981 GT4 market, the 4C market, the AMG GTR market, and the 997 Turbo market. And this means that we have new and old cars in there from different price ranges. Now, unfortunately, as you can see, I don't have the exact same date for each market. But in total, the date range covers around 1.5 years. If we look then at the price developments, then we can see that most lines look flat or show a slight increase. And this means that the median price for a used car in that market went up. Yet, you need to take into account that these are aggregated numbers. And this means that within a certain car market, there might be certain segments which went up and certain segments which went down. For example, in the Audi R8 market, you will find a big difference between the manual and automatics. Therefore, I recommend that you head over to my channel if you want to know more about a specific market. All of these markets are covered there by a separate analysis. And in those videos, you will also see if the price changes are statistically confirmed, or that it's just a result of chance. And when you're anyway visiting the channel, don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification bell so you get notified when an analysis of your dream car goes live. All right, back to the graph. I just said that most lines are flat or slightly increasing, but you can also see some lines which show a little dip in the first half of 2020 and recovered after that. And this kind of slight V-shaped pattern is visible for many markets when you look at the data on a more granular level. Now then, the amount with which a price changed depends of course heavily on the starting point, the pricing point of the market. Therefore, we need to have a look at the relative changes over time. You can see now that we have the different cars on the horizontal axis and the price change on the vertical axis. On average, prices went up with 3%. But let's have a look at some individual cars. The AMG GTR Pro is leading the bunch when it comes to value drops. It lost almost 9%. But this is of course not a surprise. The AMG GTR Pro is really new and was, just as the normal GTR, expected to drop a ton. So a drop of 9% is in that case not so bad. What is surprising, however, is the next car on the list, the Audi R8 V10. Yet, this score is relatively low due to the inclusion of the automatics, and the same goes for the V8. If we look then at the beloved 981 GT4, then we can also see a slight drop of 5%. But also this is not such a big surprise. That market is namely coming from a situation where prices were inflated. But now, let's have a look at the other end of the graph. There you will namely immediately notice the 25% value increase for the McLaren 720S. Yet, as you can see in my detailed analysis, this increase is so large because the bottom of the market moved up. And perhaps the reason for this is that also this market came from a quite extreme situation, one where prices were plummeting. And due to some data issues, this increase is perhaps a bit exaggerated. But nevertheless, prices went up. Now next to the 720S, we find a few cars which increased between 4 and 5%. We have the 997 Turbos, the F430, the ZR1 and the Z06 over here. Naturally, it is not so strange that slightly older cars like the F430 and the 997 are on this side of the graph. What is perhaps a bigger surprise is the appearance of the Z06 and the F-Type. The Z06 increase might be fueled by the scarcity in the C8 market and the combination of it being the last C7 with a manual and engine in the front. F-Type values are slightly higher than before because higher mileage cars started to bottom. So, we just saw that during the pandemic, values of collectibles fluctuated quite a bit, but that on average, they remained quite strong. After all, if we remove the two outliers, the McLaren 720S and the AMG GTR Pro, values fluctuated within a bandwidth of -5% and +5%. And to me, that's a stable market. Most used sports cars go down in value. Yet, I am fully aware that the data and the cars which I just presented to you are not an accurate representation for the used car market values or even the used sports cars values. However, the trends are different for various market segments and the explanations for the trends depend on who you ask. In April 2020, Road and Track published an article in which the vice president of JD Power PIM Consulting states that they saw a large decrease in used car values. But this concerns your average family car. For enthusiast cars, they note that values often remain strong in adverse economic conditions. Nevertheless, at the same time, experts from Sotheby's, Rally, and HIGI all agreed at that point that prices would be likely to fall. Yet, they noted that, historically, specialty car markets tend to rebound quicker than financial markets. But did prices actually fall like they claimed? TrueCar stated in an interview with CNET that prices for normal cars indeed dipped in April 2020, but that prices increased quite aggressively in September and October. They said that, with demand well above anticipated levels and lower supply due to shutdowns, it's a seller's market for new cars and trucks. Now, if we look then at the sports cars and collectible car markets, then we can see that prices remained very strong thanks to the popularity of online auctions. All Hagerty price indexes show a stable development, and the one for affordable collectibles shows sign of an exponential increase. Moreover, many articles from all over the world show that volumes and transaction values for online auctions have been very high and even record-breaking. Hagerty estimates that in 2020, the number of collectibles which trade at hand rose as much as 14%. Unsurprisingly, Bring a Trailer profited from this as sales climbed by more than 60%, selling almost 1,000 cars a month. So it appears to be so that at the beginning of the pandemic, there was still quite some uncertainty in the market. And perhaps rightfully so. We didn't really know yet what the situation was and what the impact would be. Yet, after that initial period of uncertainty, values remained flat or even went up. And that is also in line with the videos which I've been showing to you on this channel. But why on earth are prices stable or even going up? Well, that depends on the segment you're looking at. But before we continue, if you like this video, please support the channel by smashing that like button. Thank you. When we look at normal cars, we can see that it is mainly the shortage in supply in combination with stable demand which is driving prices up. As a result, dealers put markups on their cars. As I mentioned, at the same time, demand remains strong. Financing deals are attractive with the current low interest rates, and most importantly, not everyone's financial situation is impacted by the pandemic. Now, if we look then at the sports cars or collectible car market, then we can see some of the same reasons, but also some new ones. And overall, I would say that the reasons are perhaps a bit more demand driven. First, just as for normal cars, financing is still cheap and not everyone is impacted by the situation in the same way. Hagerty indicates that half of the collectible car owners have a six-figure income and that the median income is $125,000 for buyers of post-1980 cars. Second, Sotheby's states that many people simply have more time to pursue their interest in collectible cars. While quarantining, it's easy to open your PC and do some research into the car of your interest. Moreover, Hagerty indicates that this is fueled by the fact that driving is simply one of the few activities which is still allowed, at least in many countries. Third, Hagerty notes that a new group of buyers is emerging, Generation X and the Millennials. These accounted for 53% of their insurance quotes in 2020. Moreover, it might be especially this group who is fueling the rise of online auction websites. After all, personally, I used to think that this world of collectible cars auction was always a bit intransparent and closed. Online auctions, of course, change this. They offer great accessibility and transparency. All right, we know now how the recent price development relates to the historical price development and why prices developed the way they did. So what does all of this then mean for the future? Let me start by saying that this is my opinion and that no one knows for sure what we'll know in the future. Also, as you might know, I like to back up my claims about the future with model predictions, but those I don't have available here. So we need to do it with qualitative factors. Now, when it comes to everyday cars and new cars, I expect that the market will return to its normal depreciation curve once supply increases. There is no reason for mass-produced vehicles to go up in price. There is simply no scarcity. For collectible cars which are already bottomed, I expect a neutral or perhaps slight increase in values. And I have the following reasons for this. First, it is likely that there will be an uptick in inflation after the pandemic. And many research papers show that classic cars offer a decent hedge against inflation. Hence, it's likely that these type of cars keep up with the inflation. Second, most collectible cars came down a lot between 2016 and 2020. And this means that most investors were shaken out of the market and that the current prices are more healthy. Hence, I think that it is unlikely that we would see another squeeze for the same reason. Third, physical auctions will open again, and this might attract the more old-fashioned buyers again. Yet, I don't think that the online auction platforms will see a strong decline, as their audiences are a bit different. Fourth, depending on the country you live, restrictions might be so tight that you're not even allowed to do a nice road trip. Once the travel bans are lifted, demand for collectibles might increase, and I think that this will happen especially for the lower end of the market. After all, these are the cars which are really bought for enjoyment and for driving. Fifth, with strict regulations on the horizon, it starts to become a now or never scenario for many buyers. After all, if you always wanted a certain sports car and are not a fan of electrification, time is ticking. And you are not going to buy that four-cylinder AMG. You will probably be looking at an older, more raw V6, V8, V10, or perhaps V12. Now finally then, sixth, there might be some revenge spending in the market. Already in numerous places around the world, consumers are overcompensating by buying more than usual to make up for their lost shopping. And this goes especially for luxury goods like collectible cars. But I of course could be completely wrong. When you do some research on collectible car markets, you will find that they are often compared to things like the art market and the wine market. They are also called emotional assets. And in one paper about art valuations, William Baumol wrote, "Prices can float more or less aimlessly, and their unpredictable oscillations are apt to be exacerbated by the activities of those who treat such art objects as investments." And this, I think, applies to a very large extent to the collectible car markets, and then especially the top end of the market. Now, this was a different video than what I usually make, but a very interesting one to make. Yet, before we close this video, I want to say that I realized that the numbers which I presented here are in some cases at a very high level, and also that the conclusions have some limitations. Nevertheless, I hope that you enjoyed it. A huge thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next week for a new video.